Basically, in order to attract the investments, we are setting up several incentives to compensate for some infrastructure inadequacies and the cost of bureaucratic inertia, but also to level the playing field as much as possible. Some of the incentives are listed down on the screen, such as foreign exchange liberalization. We are saying that all exporters are entitled to 100% of their foreign exchange earnings. This is basically to entice all the investors that come down here to produce for export, because then it is more profitable. So take the profit 100%, but produce for export. We have VAT exemptions, and some of the goods brought in are zero-rated, more especially to reduce the costs for exporters to make Uganda-originated goods more competitive on the global market. Market access, I've already mentioned that. And then we are saying all exporters of goods and services are zero-rated for VAT. VAT is 18%, so everything that you produce and construct for export within the region is zero-rated for VAT. So the rest of the other incentives can be read there. The Uganda Revenue Authority, which is the main arm of government to collect taxes, has established a tax system, and those are the different taxes that are collectible: the corporate tax, the value-added tax, the import and excise duties, and the percentages are mentioned there: pay as you earn and rental tax from property owners. But some of these are now waived for the different investors, as will be shown in extended documentation that you may get if you are interested. The government has also established tax holidays on exportation of finished consumer and capital goods for a period of 10 years. At least 80% of production and processing of agricultural products to final goods. What this means is that you should process an agricultural good from the country, from raw to finished products. And when you do that, you qualify automatically for a tax holiday of 10 years. The government has also set up depreciation allowances. Basically, what this means is that during the taxation structure for the taxes that we are talking about, you are allowed a certain percentage of your investment tax-free. For example, the computers, 40% of their value and the data handling equipment will be tax-free. You will be only taxed for the 60% according to the applicable rates. So the rates are set for all the other consumables within the investment, such as the automobiles, buses, and etc. For the farming and manufacturing, agro-processing, those ones get even zero taxes for their trucks and automobiles. Still, there are special deductions on allowances. These are accounting operations during the tax regime. The government gives industrial building allowance on the cost of building 5%, non-taxable. Expenditures on training of employees and scientific research, 100% of this is untaxable. And there are also other exempt incomes which we can provide upon request that have been listed down by the Uganda Revenue Authority. Withholding tax is exempt on raw materials and human medicine, but this may not be applicable for construction companies. But the plant and machinery do not pay withholding tax when they are coming into the country. There are also a host of other zero-rated supplies and goods, but they are in a full list that can be studied upon request. So basically, that's the host of the tax structure and the incentives that come with investing in Uganda. And we do really hope that these are favorable enough to attract reasonable investment in Uganda, especially for export. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I think you can go to the next slide. Yes, the last one. Go forward. The last slide of the presentation.
Oh, the last slide. Yes. Okay. That one?
Yes, thank you very much. So if you have any question regarding this presentation, we still have a few more minutes to go. As a summary of it, we can see that Uganda is the right place for companies to do business. Not only it offers a window to start in East Africa, but it's also like a good window to use to go to southern part of Africa, which is very, very interesting. And also in terms of taxation, for, as a summary, if any company decides to do business in Uganda, there are several taxation exemptions that are available. And if they want to know more, so they can, the best place to contact you is the Uganda Investment Authority website, and there they will find all the information they need, right?
Exactly, exactly. We have set up this website, which is fully functional, and we are uploading most of the information that you need in terms of tax incentives and allowances onto this website. You will be able to find it there.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And so we've got a company from Poland, for instance. So if they decide to do business in Uganda, so basically, what is the best way to do business in Uganda? To come and start on your own, or to have to find a local partner and basically partner with this company and start trading or doing business in Uganda?
The best way that we are promoting is a joint venture between a foreign firm and a local firm, simply because this will come with a number of advantages to the economy. You are boosting employment to the local Ugandan, but you are also transferring technology to the local Ugandan. Now, what the local Ugandan firm will do is that it will bring its wealth of experience operating on the local market and partner with the foreign firm, which comes with the new technology and easier ways of doing business. And we find this platform to be one of the best to do business in Uganda. We have some of the firms, the foreign firms that have come here and also managed because the Uganda Investment Authority is here to help you settle into the country and basically introduce you to all the other state actors that help you to establish your business. But like I said, the other is the preferred mode, but you can come as a different company, no problem in that regard.
Okay, so the best way is to have a local partner, find a local partner, and then
yes,
benefit from the different exemptions, and then
yes,
your organization can help in setting up the relationship. Okay.
Exactly.